Canada, 1990. And as the Spice suspension collapses, it goes out of control. Off the track, across the grass and into the wall. Bouncing back, it narrowly misses the Porsche of the Almeras brothers, unkindly dubbed during this season the Almeras Triangle, on account of the large number of race cars which disappeared while...
Engine into that one. We have been rolling in Amazuka with the new works engine, the water cooled engine. One the engine is going for up part, and we change also the engine in this car now. And in the D car we have the 2.8 engine, so it is running well for the race up. So they are now running with the 2.8 engine for the race tomorrow.
And Clark Kerr, they haven't actually put a red flag out, but all the cars have come into the pits anyway.
To be honest, you can't really say that it is...
Hier so einige Crash. Hier sehen wir den ersten und der traf dummerweise gleich den Mercedes mit der Startnummer 1, den von Jean-Louis Schlesser, der hier in die Leitplanken geflogen ist, nachdem Mercedes mit dem neuen C11 schon während des Freitagstrainings ja enorme Probleme hatte. Technische Probleme, kam hier letztlich das Aus für das neue Auto und man entschloss sich von Mercedes aus in den C9, den Wagen des vergangenen Jahres, umzusteigen. Böse Geschichte hier, ich glaube, war schwierig zu...
And all the rest of the hard work that goes into making a race car chassis competitive. Here at Brands Hatch, it was clear that things were not yet sorted. Despite the evidence of speed and performance, Julian Bailey overcooked it, perhaps over-enthused it would be a better word, and sailed off into the gravel at Clearways, hurting only his pride. And back in the pits, Bob Wallach was black flagged for receiving push-start assistance on the grid at the beginning of the race, and his day was over. So too was the day of the Musato Lancia. Turn 14 claimed its first victim of the race, signalled by this huge cloud of dust. Before the race, it had been described as awesome, and Mara Baudi, in fact, said that it was a big adventure, and the drivers had to pass it 109 times during the course of the race.
Mister of Weidler and Sala, now right at the back of the field. Problem for Dalmas. Dalmas in the lead. Oh! Dalmas with terrible problems, the car on its roof and the crews and marshals on their way, and this is a serious situation with the possibility of fuel leaking, fire starting. Urgent action required down in the pits, the news coming over the crackly radio to them. Dalmas is helped out, obviously shaken but unhurt. The car is righted. A disastrous situation for Dalmas and Peugeot. Approaching the second chicane at about 180 miles an hour, the rear brakes lock up, the car over the curbs, and suddenly airborne and rocking, rolling and turning over. Thank goodness Dalmas had the good sense to come in and have his seatbelts done up.